I am the cold, I am the frost, I am the ice age, a time when Earth was locked beneath a vast white silence. My story began not with a bang but with a slow creeping chill, starting 2.6 million years ago. Subtle shifts in Earth's orbit and tilt invited winter to linger, turning brief chills into millennia of ice. Imagine summers growing weaker, winters stretching longer, snow piling up year after year, compressing into dense, heavy ice. This was my birth glaciers forming in the north, growing too massive for mountains to contain, spreading southward like a frozen tide. I was not a single event but a series of advances and retreats, glacial and interglacial periods, defining the Pleistocene epoch. As I grew, the world changed, air crisped, oceans receded, coastlines shifted and land bridges emerged. The world before me was warmer, gentler. I brought a stark, majestic beauty, towering ice cliffs, frozen plains and star-filled skies. My arrival was gradual but my impact was immense. I set the stage for a new, challenging world. Life would have to adapt or perish. My story was just beginning, a tale of transformation that would shape the planet forever. Welcome to the Ice Age. My reign lasted over 2.5 million years, a cycle of freezing and thawing, not endless winter. Glaciers advanced, covering a third of Earth, then retreated as the world warmed, only to return again. My rhythm was set by the heavens. Milankovitch cycles, Earth's orbit, tilt and wobble, altered sunlight, fueling my icy grip. When summers grew too cool to melt winter snow, my power surged. Expanding ice reflected sunlight, amplifying the cold in a self-perpetuating loop. Falling greenhouse gases deepened the chill. My last great advance, the last glacial maximum, peaked 20,000 years ago. Ice sheets miles thick pressed down continents. North America, Europe, and Asia were transformed under my weight. This was the height of my power, a world ruled by ice. My frozen world teemed with giants, megafauna adapted to the cold. Woolly mammoths with shaggy coats and curved tusks roamed in herds, sweeping snow to reach frozen grasses. Saber-toothed cats, muscular and deadly, hunted bison and young mammoths with their massive fangs. Giant ground sloths, towering as high as elephants, pulled down branches for food. Short-faced bears, dire wolves, and cave lions prowled the icy plains and forests. Ancient bison and woolly rhinoceroses grazed, while giant beavers and other unique creatures thrived. Even the smallest animals were built for survival in my harsh climate. It was a world of titans, each uniquely adapted to the cold. My era was a testament to nature's resilience and creativity. Life found a way, even in the heart of the Ice Age. My reign tested a clever, resilient species, early humans. For them, survival meant adaptation, hunting mammoths for food, clothing, and shelter, using every part of the beast. Success required teamwork, planning, and communication, skills that forged strong communities. Mastery of fire became essential, providing warmth, safety, and a center for life. Humans sought shelter in caves where they painted stunning images of the animals they depended on. My glaciers redrew the world's map, opening migration routes like the Bering Land Bridge. Driven by necessity, humans crossed into new continents, spreading across the globe. My cold did not break them, it made them stronger, smarter, and more connected. The Ice Age was a crucible for human ingenuity. In my world, humanity learned to thrive. I was a sculptor, reshaping continents with ice, rock, and time. My glaciers acted as colossal bulldozers, carving valleys, fjords, and basins, leaving behind glacial erratics as silent witnesses. Yosemite's valleys and Norway's fjords are my handiwork, shaped by the relentless flow of ice. The Great Lakes were born as my ice sheets gouged deep basins, later filled by meltwater. My weight pressed the land down. When I melted, the crust rebounded, a process still ongoing. Meltwater formed vast lakes and sudden floods carved dramatic landscapes like the channeled Scablands. Sea levels dropped, exposing new lands and connecting continents. Doggerland, Beringia, Sahul. These land bridges became highways for migration, altering the course of life on Earth. I didn't just change the weather, I changed the very shape of the world. My legacy is written in the land itself. My reign ended as Earth's orbit shifted, bringing stronger summer sunlight and melting my icy grip. The Great Thaw began, glaciers retreated, rivers of meltwater surged and sea levels rose. Land bridges vanished, isolating continents and species. Forests replaced the cold steppes. The world I shaped faded away, Megafauna, once rulers of my realm, struggled to survive in the warming world. Many vanished forever. My retreat redrew coastlines, filled lakes, and left fertile plains. Human societies flourished in the new Holocene age, but my mark remained everywhere. Valleys, lakes, and soils bear my signature. I am a reminder that Earth's climate is ever-changing, powerful, and unpredictable. My story is a frozen chapter in the planet's history. The legacy of the Ice Age endures, in the land, in life, and in memory.